Good morning. We are extremely pleased that you are here. We are extremely pleased that we are here. It is good to come together for the purpose of co-creating. Do you agree? You are knowing what you are wanting. You are enjoying the evolution of your personal desire. Oh, yes. Do you realize that you are vibrational beings mostly? And that everything in the universe is responding to your point of attraction because you are sending off a vibrational signal? If you know that, you are weird. If you know that, you are not a normal human. But you do have an advantage that normal humans don't have, because you then understand how things work for you. You then have control. Once you understand that, once you understand that you're putting out a signal and that that signal is being responded to, then it's not hard to figure things out once you begin making the correlation between your signal and what's happening. So how do you make the correlation? How do you translate this vibration into something that's meaningful? You do it in a lot of ways without even knowing you're doing it. You translate vibration, and that's why you see. But most people usually don't think of sight as a vibrational thing, but it is. Easier to hear it about your hearing, isn't it? Translation of vibration. What you smell is a translation of vibration. Your touching is, you're translating, even your tongue is translating vibration. Different food has different vibration, and that's why it tastes different to you. Everything is vibrational. So when you begin to accept that this is a vibrational universe that you are translating, and that your senses translate it, and then you begin to become consciously aware of the most significant translator of vibration that you possess, which is your emotional center, then you begin to understand how things fit together. Before you understand how things fit together, you have to understand what the things are that are fitting together. In other words, what makes the vibration that you call emotion is the positioning or the relationship between the vibration that you are offering from your broader non-physical perspective and the vibration that you're offering because of the thought you're thinking right now. In other words, you are more than you see in these physical bodies, and you're more than the vibration that we've just described that you are translating physically. You are a source energy being. Doctors, as they are looking at you, can see the energy in the sense that they say, well, you're alive, or they see the absence of it in your physical vessel when they say, well, you are dead or not alive. But they don't understand that there is a projection and a receiving of a vibration, you could call it consciousness, you could call it source, that is coming to you and through you all day, every day. It's the whole of you. It's the eternal part of you. It's the part of you that was broadcasting even before you were born into this body. It's the part of you that eternally is broadcasting a signal, meaning thinking thoughts, having consciousness, having knowingness, having beingness. In other words, you are an eternally broadcasting being. So here you are in your physical body. Now, the part of you that's here in this physical body is only a small part of the whole of who you are. It's sort of like, as you're in your physical body, you may be thinking about the work that you're doing. You rarely do, but sometimes you do. Or you may be thinking about the love that you're making or the love that you're having, or you may be thinking about the car that you're driving. But you are never doing all of those things at the same time. In other words, you are projecting consciousness relative to different topics. You get that, don't you? You could be a master carpenter, but while you're bowling, you're not usually thinking about that. And if you are, you're not doing a very good job of bowling. Does anyone bowl? So the point that we're making here is that this point of consciousness that is really who you are is huge in relationship to the personality consciousness that you know as you. It's a much bigger part of you that was and is non-physical. And that non-physical you is having a relationship with you all the time. The question is, are you conscious about the relationship that you're having with the larger part of you? How consciously connected to this source energy part of you are you? Now, emotionally speaking, when you're thrilled, when you're in a state of appreciation, when you are having a moment where you feel so deeply in love, when you feel passionate about something, that means that the vibrational frequency within you, caused by the focused thought that you've got going on in that moment, is so in alignment with the vibrational frequency of who you really are that there's no resistance. It's just total allowing of the fullness of you to manifest or be present in this moment.